So I had a question from someone who made a comment on one of the YouTube videos, and they wanted to know about the anti-aging creams, if they should use those, and do they actually work? And the answer is no, I'm sorry. They don't make your skin any younger. What they do is make your skin a little bit tighter, and they do add more hydration on a temporary basis, but not actually younger. And in one study, which I'll put down below, found that the anti-aging creams will reduce your wrinkles by less than 10% over 12 weeks. 10% is not even noticeable to the human eye, so you're not gonna really see too much. So what is the solution? Is there a way to reverse the aging process or at least slow it down? And the answer is yes, if you understand the simple concept of inside out versus outside in. There's no way you're gonna actually try to get the body younger by applying something topically or trying to work from the outside in. It really comes from the inside out. And it's a combination of several things, but you really want to look at the balance of how much oxidation is going on or things that are breaking your tissues down or destroying your DNA versus the antioxidants in the body, which are countering all this free radical damage. And just so you know, a free radical is an unpaired electron. So let's say, for example, we have this atom right here that's supposed to be spinning around and it only has one electron. It doesn't have the pair of electron over here, okay? It's missing it. What happens, it makes the atom very, very unstable. And so it can create destruction to the body. And an antioxidant will donate an electron to stabilize this, to create less damage. And there's two sources of antioxidants. One is exogenous, that means outside the body, from your diet. You're eating leafy vegetables, you're eating cruciferous vegetables. It is giving you antioxidants. And also, vitamins act as antioxidants, vitamin E, vitamin A, vitamin C, even vitamin B1 can act as an antioxidant. And they always come in networks, because when an antioxidant donates its electron, it then becomes unstable and it can create some problems. So it will borrow an electron from another antioxidant. So they come in networks. So you have the food that you eat with antioxidants, okay, that's called exogenous. Then you have endogenous antioxidants. Your body actually can make antioxidants. So that's cool. So the combination of both need to be in such quantity to counter the amount of oxidation coming in from the environment and from your diet. That's just making things break down and making you age prematurely. So what could make this worse? The big thing is glucose, high carb diets that will trigger insulin, which will then combine with certain proteins in your body and cause this other phenomena called glycation. So when you combine sugar with a protein, it creates a protein that's now non-functional. And that's gonna make your tissues less elastic, and that's gonna make you look a lot older. And another term for that is advanced glycation end products. And that is created by glucose, having a high amount of glucose in the diet. The other thing that's interesting is nutritional deficiencies can fail to supply certain biochemical enzymes that are supposed to repair and keep your tissue stable at the cellular level. So nutrition is a really key part in slowing the aging process down faster than it's going. So the worst case scenario is this combination between a high carb diet and low nutrients. That's going to age your skin. It's going to make you look older. It's going to age the inside of the body. And on the flip side of that, if you switch your fuel from glucose to ketones, ketones act as an antioxidant, which is really, really cool. So it's a much healthier fuel source. And I always recommend the healthy version of the ketogenic diet. So that way we can actually add the nutrients from the food to prevent the free radical damage and keep your skin and your tissues looking healthy. So there's also hormones involved. The hormone that you really want to preserve is growth hormone. Growth hormone is all about anti-aging. It's all about keeping your proteins intact. And I'm talking about the skin, the hair, the nails, the inside of the body. Growth hormone is responsible for that. As we age, growth hormone goes down. We want to keep it as high as possible. So there's certain things that lower growth hormone and there's certain things that will increase it. Glucose, by the way, will lower growth hormone. Insulin will lower growth hormone. So high carbohydrate diets, stay away from them. Cortisol from stress will also inhibit growth hormone. Cortisol is very destructive on your proteins, on your skin, and it will age you at an accelerated rate. Alcohol is another thing that is very dehydrating. It will inhibit growth hormone. It will make you look old. All right, so how do we raise growth hormone? Well, exercise, okay? But make sure you don't overtrain. If you exercise correctly with enough recovery, you can spike growth hormone by 500 to 700%. So that's one key factor, regular exercise. Plus, the exercise can, if done correctly, reduce the cortisol, the stress. And then fasting. Fasting is probably one of the most important things if you wanted to slow down the aging process and look younger. Also, when you do periodic prolonged fasting, you stimulate stem cells. Stem cells actually help you regrow new tissue like your immune system, your gut, your skin. So fasting is probably one of the biggest things that can help you look younger. It can stimulate growth hormone by 1,300 to 2,000%. And then we have sleep. Sleep is another key factor to enhancing growth hormones. So if you do intermittent fasting and prolonged fasting, you get enough sleep, you keep your stress down, you exercise, you do healthy keto, that is your best bet to slow down the aging process. But to actually think that you can actually do it with a cream, it's just not going to work. All right, guys, thanks for watching. And check out a couple of these very interesting videos I have related to growth hormone.